Fingers were all bloody. He staggered toward the far side of that room and then he grabbed up a poker from the fireplace. With a scream, I threw myself at the table and grabbed the box that was on it. I pulled at the lid, but it didn't open. The box slid out of my hands. It fell heavily and it was smashed. It was weird. As we stared, we saw instruments that a dentist uses. Mixed in there, I could see 32 white objects. They were small and jagged and seemed made of ivory. Next moment, I held one in my hand. I remembered it. I recognized one of the magnificent teeth of my cousin Berenice. My obsession of earlier, it was created by her teeth. The sight of them had consumed me, and it had been fully 6 months since the night of her death. The night that I had blanked out. There wasn't a thing that I could recall. Memory failed. Had I killed her, I wondered.
I recently read that story of yours, Mr. Poe. It's fiction, but hearing you narrate it, I begin to believe it could be true. Fascinating.
Who are you, sir?
Alan Foster, writer for The Times.
Ah. The journalist who's been storming me with letters for the last 5 days.
Because you've refused me an appointment, you forced me to come here to see you. It doesn't happen very often that Edgar Allan Poe comes here to London.
This is in fact my first visit to England. And it will also be my final visit.
Oh, has London disappointed you?
No, life itself. Sit down here, please. Let me inform you, Mr. Foster, that I am not a novelist, but one of your colleagues, a reporter. Every story that I've ever written is true. It really happened.
Oh, yes, I'm quite sure it did, with everything that you have written. You see, it happened in your imagination.
No, it didn't. It's pure and simple truth, let me assure you, young man.
I believe there are only 7 years difference between us. It could be eight.
Eight, then. But to me, it's a lifetime, you see, and I await here something that doesn't exist. My death.
You're extraordinary. I'd been led to believe that death is certain, yet you say it doesn't exist. It does, though.
You're confusing death with the tomb, young man. It's a common mistake.
The sheet of marble that'll cover all of us assures us that it's certainly the tomb, but life has not been ended. Of the people who are buried, there are many who haven't died. They survive. I've researched this.
Oh, I think you're making fun of me. A man of your great intelligence certainly doesn't believe that there's a hereafter. Oh, no, no. I'd like to give you more credit.
My gratitude. You have properly insulted my intelligence with, I'd say, an exquisite elegance.
If I've insulted you, I didn't mean to, and I apologize. You've always had my admiration and all my respect as well, and you still do. However, I disagree with you. I think life's cycle terminates with death and entombment. After that, well, there's nothing. It's the end. If there is some existence after that, if there is, I firmly believe that it's in the spirit. That may never die. Nobody ever returns from the dead as in your stories. I admit that I'm afraid. Yet I'm not afraid of the dead. Not at all. It's the living. Oh, yes. My fear is of the living. They're the ones who can harm us, you must agree.
Pardon me, sir. I'm Sir Thomas Blackwood. I'll bet £100 sterling on the theory that you, sir, cannot spend a single night in my castle in Providence.
Why? Do you believe that I might run away from the place?
No. You'd remain there. Of all those who have agreed to take up my wager, not one has ever lived to run away.
I'm sorry that I'm unable to take you up on your bet.
Oh, perhaps it's just as well, young man. I've heard of this castle of Sir Thomas. It's on a cliff overlooking the valley in the Providence vicinity. Approximately 12 months ago, a bride and groom visited there. They were the last.
That's right. He was a cousin of my wife's.
The information I was given was that, and Sir Thomas might dispute it, they were never seen again.
Now, these honeymooners decided that they'd stay. Is that it? You don't want me to think that they disappeared into nothing. Whether they still live or if they died, I'm certain that they left.
Mr. Poe is telling the truth. He happens to be right. They remain there. They are both resting there, the family cemetery. Each year I search like this, I seek to locate a courageous man who'll say that he's willing to spend the night in the castle and dispel the legend. But you are quite a nice young man, and I feel grateful that you decided to refuse to accept the wager.
It's not that I don't want to wager, my lord. I'm not a coward. The fact is, I lack the required sum. You see, most journalists these days don't have money. Am I right? For 10, I'd be glad to...
You'd take the wager for 10 sterling?
Right away.
Then you will go there tonight. The night of the dead. It is only from midnight tonight, the first midnight in November, until the sunrise, that you may see the dead come back to perform again those tragedies which had cost them their lives.
Well, you know, this experience is likely to prove a valuable addition to my thesis. I have an excellent title already. The Castle of Terror.
Please think about whether you really want to go there.
I look forward to it. But you, sir, I want that interview now.
No. You must go there immediately. It's a distance away. It will take us at least about 2 hours in my carriage.
What about my interview with Poe here?
If it's so important to you, perhaps we can talk while we're traveling. Do you mind if I accompany you? I would like to.
I assure you, I'll be honored.
Come on, I'm ready to go. Coming, sir? During the journey, I should be able to get a good interview tonight.
Of course.
Thank you, gentlemen. Good night. Good night.
Gentlemen, we're here. Mr. Foster, you still have time if you want to return with us.
No, thank you. I intend to win the wager.
Please think it over again.
My thanks for the interview. I fully expect to return and to be able to see it published someday.
You may. We'll be back to pick you up at dawn tomorrow morning.
Let me wish you the best of luck.
You'll find the castle through that gate, and I also want to wish you good luck.
Thank you. Let a mirror frighten you as this dusty one had. That was just your own reflection there. Yet you'll have to be suspicious and search very carefully every room. You know, it's important to remain calm. Whatever happens tonight, you will have to survive till morning. I decided to make notes. Would you mind?
Did my brother send you?
If you're referring to Lord Thomas Blackwood, yes. I'm Alan, Alan Foster.
My name is Elizabeth.
Your brother led me to believe the castle was uninhabited.
I see. Dear Thomas tells that to everyone, because to him I'm dead.
What?
Yes. Because ever since I left his world, I came here to search for happiness with the man I love.
And you could never succeed in convincing him, reconciling him.
A lord will never accept his own gardener as a brother-in-law. Since then, I've been alone.
I'll go. I remind you of the past.
Are you afraid of me?
No. But if I'd known that you were here, I wouldn't have accepted your brother's wager.
Ah, yes, of course. That's the wager my brother makes every year, so that I may have company for one night. And also to give credit to all the fantastic stories that are told about this castle.
Is it fantasy or real?
Like all fantastic stories, mere coincidence and little reality. But don't you want to win the wager?
Is there anyone that has succeeded in the past?
The past doesn't count. You are here tonight. You'll win and get rich.
I'll be truthful. I could wager only £10. I'm a poor man.
Then you won't become rich, but you can help me spite my brother. Come. I've prepared your room upstairs.
You knew I'd be here?
Naturally. Every year on this night, someone arrives.
On this night, eh? The night of the dead.
Afraid?
Who did this?
Nobody. The candles are being extinguished simply by the wind. You're trembling.
Oh. It seems cold in here.
Come this way. Must I have to give you courage? A woman? That doesn't seem right now, does it?
Look there.
What is it?
A portrait. It's affected by the light. First time that it did that, I'd moved the candles.
What did they do to it?
Made her eyes seem to glow. This entire painting of your ancestor seemed alive.
But Julia isn't a Blackwood. And she is exactly my age.
Oh. Forgive me. I'm making a lot of errors. I'm truly sorry. I'd better leave you alone. Be so good as to make my apologies to Julia, though I haven't had the pleasure of meeting her.
You're going to meet her very soon.
I found that piece of lace as I came in. I supposed it belonged to someone here.
Thank you. This way, Alan. Come with me.
This is so different from what I expected. I was prepared to spend the night with horrible ghosts, and instead I find you.
I'm glad you feel that way. I hope you feel at home because you're nice. Yes, I like you very much. And Junior will like you. But she must realize that my brother sent you to visit me. In here, the things have been kept more orderly, as you can see. I've been without servants ever since the day that I arrived. It's not been easy seeing that these things stay in readiness for a visitor like you, Alan. Come here and sit next to me. I want to hear what's happening in the world outside.
Well, there's nothing new. People are born and others die every day. Business seems as usual. In fact, the world goes on. It remains the same. You haven't missed anything while you stayed here in your own world, and you seem content. Are you not? It's a shame, though, that society is deprived of the pleasure of seeing such a charming woman as you.
You're very kind. Do you really consider that I'm an attractive woman, Alan?
Oh, yes, Elizabeth. I'm being very truthful.
I know you are. But now I'm very anxious to hear all about you.
I'm afraid there's not much to tell, but you asked me, so I'll try. I'm single. ever been inside a prison. In London, I earn a steady living as a writer. To be honest, I've been very lonely.
Tonight, you won't be so lonely.
I don't believe we've met.
Earlier tonight, I was admiring your lovely portrait.
Yet Elizabeth is the woman you admire.
Elizabeth is really beautiful, isn't she? But you are also beautiful, my dear Julia.
Well, you are kind. I envy you, you know that.
Julia, you'd better not start trying to cause any trouble.
Elizabeth, really? That's being quite unjust to me.
Is it? Just remember, he was sent to see me.
Are you certain, my dear? Is it true, Mr. Foster?
Oh, well, no. I'd been led to believe that it's part of a wager. That's why I came here.
You see, Elizabeth?
I'm warning you, Julia. Mind your own business.
Oh, don't threaten me. As you can see, Mr. Foster is finding this very embarrassing, Elizabeth. I have the feeling that he might like to be left alone. Why don't you leave?
Be still.
You're being childish again.
Well, I'll leave then.
It's getting late, and I guess I'd better leave also. Until tomorrow, then. And I hope that you'll have a peaceful night.
Will I be seeing you tomorrow morning?
No, I'm sorry. I won't be here in the day.
You mean you're leaving?
Not at all. I only said I shan't be here tomorrow morning in the daylight.
That's being unfair. He's my guest. Will you stop staring at me like that? He belongs only to me. You've no right to interrupt our visit.
Oh, yes, I did. He might have learned the secret. Yet maybe you'd like that. Would you like him to learn it? Yes or no?
I can't let him know. If he did, he'd never be able to face me, and he'd try to leave. He must never learn the truth about this horrible place.
He will learn the truth. Just see him again, and I will tell him.
Julia. I need him. I need to be with him.
Are you in love with him?
Yes, I love him.
Poor dear. And can you really expect that you'll be happy, Elizabeth?
Happy? Yes. I'll be happy with him.
No. You won't be happy with any man.
I'm certain that with Alan here, I can really be happy. You're speaking like this, Julia, only because you're so jealous. That's the only reason you're so against us.
No. You're liable to feel disappointed.
I'll not be. I've dreamed of this night. At last I can go away with the man I love.
You can't leave, Elizabeth. You're trapped in this castle.
Trapped here? No, it's not true. It can't be. It can't be.
I see. I feared you'd be asleep. I hope you won't be too angry. I wanted to see you.
I'm pleased you're here. I wanted to see you again. You've made me feel so much at home tonight. And I'm very attracted to you, my dear.
Alan, dear, are you really?
Yes, Elizabeth.
Thank you.
Your hair, it's lovely. Your beauty is strange and very unusual.
Carlos, I see that you were planning to read this. In that case, I will leave.
No, please stay here. Promise? Elizabeth, I must tell you that I think you're the loveliest girl on this earth.
Oh, Alan, I'm so very happy you said that. Kiss me. You'll be mine then. Kiss me. Love me, Alan. Love me. Oh, yes, my dearest. Keep on embracing me. I want to absorb the warmth of your body. Kiss me, warm me, dearest Alan. My dearest, you will give me life.
I tried telling her. I tried. I'll make her remember this night. Elizabeth? Yes, she went back in there again.
I knew she'd see she did. It's too late.
She'll be sorry she did, pretending to be something that she isn't. I'd better tell Herbert. Excuse me.
But that's not true. I've not been happier. We'll be together from now on.
No, apart. Your life is today. But mine is the past.
I don't believe that, Elizabeth.
I can't be in your world. I remain in mine.
Elizabeth!
Yes, Alan.
Oh, thank heavens. For a moment I thought that your heart had stopped.
My heart isn't beating, Alan. It hasn't beaten for 10 years. I'm dead, Alan. Dead.
Elizabeth!
No! No, Herbert, no!
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth! Elizabeth!
Everything is possible here tonight. You must not be concerned about Elizabeth.
What happened? She disappeared.
Yes, yes, she did.
It was horrible. Where is she? I must find her.
It's no use.
You mean she's dead? But if she was killed, I will have to find her body.
You will not find it. It does not exist in your world.
You, sir, who are you?
I am Dr. Carlos.
Carlos? The famous doctor and scientist?
Yes.
There's been no news of you for years, and I concluded that you had died.
Did you? Perhaps it's accurate to say that I stopped surviving in your world. I wanted to try some experiments, and I wasn't allowed to do it. But you've suffered a shock. I want to prescribe something to drink. This way. I have an excellent whiskey in my study. Come in, won't you? The drink will relax your nerves, Foster. Your name is Foster, isn't it?
How do you know?
I overheard you speaking to Elizabeth.
You heard everything?
Yes. I heard every word. And I also saw what happened. But I was unable to intervene in any way. You will understand the reason. Sit down, please. Sit down and let the drink relax you.
It's impossible. It seems as if this is a nightmare. I feel convinced Elizabeth's alive. I held her in my arms. I felt life in her body. I saw her living.
It's because at that moment she lived with the strength of her senses, and they never can die.
I don't understand.
In all human beings, there are three forms of life. The weakest of them is the human body. Then the spirit that is indestructible. Then the senses. I proved that they're not eternal, but continue normally after death in some bodies. Experimenting with this theory, I proved that the senses remain strongest when a human being is torn from life by an act of violence. I've seen this frequently when there is emotion. In other words, death isn't completely accepted unless the victim is ready to die.
I think that's completely absurd.
I'll prove my thesis then. To conduct my experiments in privacy, I rented this castle from Lord Blackwood years ago, away from a suspicious world. You will now see how successful I was. Now be careful, because he's very dangerous. At this moment, the snake here is ready to strike in his own defense. I'll take its life. Yet it will continue to live through the senses even though life is out of the body. And survival through the senses is even stronger in humans.
Doctor, I have seen Elizabeth. And alive. And I feel she didn't die. You have not proven your theory. Because I still feel unconvinced she's been killed. It's over. The serpent must be dead.
See if it is. Put out your hand. It's still dangerous. As you can see, the senses are still living. Its flesh has been killed, but the senses can live on indefinitely.
You may be right.
This is only a small illustration of theories I have proven here. You've been a witness to life after death. Are you persuaded now the theory is correct?
A reptile perhaps can exist after death, but tell me, Doctor, can a human?
You don't believe it. Then I'll show you further proof. You've already seen Elizabeth. You have held her closely. And you felt the reactions of a living body as you embraced her. However, Elizabeth, rest there beneath the earth. She's been dead many years.
And the others?
They are there also, victims of their destiny.
What destiny?
Come with me. I shall explain. In a few minutes more, the dead will relive their last 5 minutes in which they encountered their destiny. Only a man as sick as Lord Thomas would send you here on the 2nd of November. He's as sadistic as his grandfather, the first Count of Black Blood.
Blackwood.
He had the name changed to Blackwood, but the first Count was known as Black Blood originally. He was made a lord when he became a hangman and hung criminals from the trees. He was infamous as the Hangman of London. In many ways, Lord Thomas is even worse than his ancestor.
Please, Doctor, I beg of you. Tell me of Elizabeth.
It is the hour. Words have no meaning. Look in there.
Would you like some water?
Yes, thank you. What do you want?
I must talk to you. Please don't say no.
So nice to see you home again.
Thank you, Julia. I feel very glad to be here once again and to be with my lovely wife. My Elizabeth.
A magnificent party, William.
Are you leaving?
Yes, I'm sorry. I have to be in London for a conference in the morning, so we'll have to start early.
Do you really have to be going? Couldn't you stay longer?
I would like to. Thank you, my dear. The castle seems so gay tonight. Thanks to you, it's filled with life.
William, we really must be going home.
I was impressed with America. I found there a certain driving force. I noticed there much more vitality than in Europe, more than I've seen in France or
Italy. Then you had a good journey.
But I'm glad that my husband has returned safely to me.
Naturally.
Oh, allow me.
No, no. I want to show them out, if you don't mind, my dear. Thank you.
Good night, Thomas.
And to you, William.
Good night, Cynthia.
Good night, Elizabeth. I trust we'll see you again soon.
Good night.
Your husband was gone. You swore you'd love me. Me and not him. And now that he's come back, I can't bear the thought of you in his arms. I won't allow it.
He's my husband. Did you forget that? Let go of me.
I'm warning you. Before it's too late, give him up. Give him up. Elizabeth.
Don't.
It's getting late. They have a rendezvous with death. They'll keep it, they have to. Every death is repeated tonight. Come.
Yeah! one is holding you here. You wanted to witness this, Foster. But everything you see is in the past now.
It's obvious. This is merely a trick, just some magic is all.
Be convinced the dead are in a different dimension. They are dwelling beyond our reach. You must learn to accept it.
Go away! Carvus, I'm sick of your horrors tonight.
There is more for you to see, Foster. Watch closely. The dead are living on this night.
I don't want to see. I want no more of your tricks! Carvus! Elizabeth! Carvus!
I've lost. Thank you.
devils!
Thank you.
Look out!
It's over now, Foster. You have seen how I met my destiny.
Marvelous, perfect for our wedding night.
A night of love and terror, according to what Sir Thomas told us earlier.
Don't leave me alone.
Why? Are you really afraid, Mrs. Perkins?
Yes, but not of you.
They'll be killed. They'll come back. I warn you!
Telling me you're afraid of a few ghosts.
Well, I heard a sound. I'm sure I did.
I'd better check.
Better not run away.
Your blood so that they can return to life next year. You must run. Please, that way.
Elizabeth!
Follow me.
Elizabeth! Elizabeth! Thank you.
Soon now it will be light.
Escape your destiny.
Your blood means our life.
No!
Your blood means life a year from now.
Elizabeth, what do they want?
Quickly, I will try to save you.
Tell me what they want.
Blood to live. The same blood I must have to give my body one more night of life.
I don't believe it.
Alan, how I love you, Alan. Uselessly, absurdly, as I wasn't able in my life. It'll mean their deaths if you escape. Through here, I want you to go back to where life is denied me. Go quickly.
We must escape together.
I can't. No. No, please. I can't go back. Your world's not mine. Alan, I can't. I can't.
You can.
No.
Elizabeth, I can feel the life in your body. You must come with
me. I can't.
Yes.
Alan, I can't go with you. I beg you, let go of me, please. I'm dead, Alan. I can't leave here. I can't. It's impossible.
This way.
Our worlds can never be together.
Honey.
No, Alan. No, Alan. I'm dead. I'm dead. Goodbye, Alan. Blood will be ours.
You cannot escape us.
It is your destiny.
Your blood will be ours.
Your blood will be our life.
Your blood will be ours.
You cannot escape us. Through you we will live.
You cannot escape.
Your blood will be our life.
Cannot escape.
No!
Your blood will be our life.
You cannot escape. Your blood will be ours.
Your blood will be our life.
Thank you.
waiting. So you can see he's won the bet.
Rafe, stop by the gate.
Foster.
The Knight of the Dead has claimed another victim. I'm sorry, but I have to collect my wager. Now we're even. Come, Poe. I will arrange to have him buried in the cemetery in there.
When I finally write this story, I'm afraid they'll say it's unbelievable.
Stayed with me, Alan.
Yes, Elizabeth.